We're joined by Joe Judge, the 19th head coach in the history of the New York Football Giants. Coach, first of all, welcome to the New York Giants organization. What was it like when you got the call to find out that the Giants had entrusted the head coaching job to you?
It was very exciting. It was very humbling to come to a great franchise like this and represent a city like New York. It's a big task at hand. Right now, I'm just focused on getting to work, and I want to do everything I can to help this team win.
What were some of the key things that you felt pushed you over the top? Because obviously you had to figure when you were coming in, interviewing for the job, special teams coaches don't normally get head coaching jobs. Obviously John Harbaugh's had a lot of success. What were some of the things that kind of you felt pushed you over the top?
You know, when I took this interview, I had a simple approach. I'm coming to have a conversation. I'm going to tell them what I believe in. I'm going to tell them fundamentally where I see my program going. And if that lines up with their vision and their philosophy, then great. And it turned out that it did. And I sat down with Mr. Mara and Mr. Gettleman for a long time. We had a lot of conversations. And it was very reassuring when we realized that, you know, our philosophies and approach to the game were very much the same.
Explain to the fans what a Joe Judge football team needs to look like, in your opinion.
Look, I'm a little bit old school in my philosophy on football. I think it's a tough game. It's a contact game. If you want to win games, you have to be a physical team. You got to run the ball, stop the run, and cover kicks. Those are three things you have to be a physical team. All right, we're going to look for smart, tough, fundamentally sound players. My job as a head coach is simple. Make sure we play fundamentally sound, all right, and make sure we can handle the situations with pressure.
Having worked under Coach Belichick and Coach Saban in your time at Alabama, what are some of the things that you took from them? And I think that's one of the questions from one of our fans, Zach, in New York. Some of the lessons that you took from those places that you've been.
Well, I'll tell you what, working with Coach Saban, it's like drinking from a fire hose. It wasn't one lesson I learned, but it was that every time he talked to the staff or talked to the team, it wasn't about what to do, it was how to do it, what it's supposed to look like, and why it's important. And I think I took the big picture right there in instructing in that players need to know not only what to do, but how to do it, what the end result should be, and then why it's important. What you find out with players is when you explain the why to them, above all, you find out that as players, they can make adjustments in game and sometimes find better techniques to get the job done. And as a coach, you'll learn a lot more from the players when you build up their ability and versatility to think on their feet and make adjustments as the game goes.
So JD in New York wants to know, a loyal Giants fan, in three words, how would you describe your coaching style?
I think you have to describe coaching style like you describe your team. Smart, tough, and fundamentally sound.
You come from the Patriots, obviously, and the tradition that's there. We're sitting here in the Quest Diagnostics Training Center. The Giants have their own championship tradition. Four Super Bowl wins plus the NFL championships prior to the Super Bowl era. What kind of burden does that bring to this job for you and sort of the tradition that you're looking to continue here?
You got to take it step by step. Look, it's a big task, but you got to take it step by step and just think about the process, what you have to do every day. At the end of the day, the little steps will lead up to the big accomplishments. So I'm focused on the details, and I'm focused on winning every day, one day at a time. You're not going to accomplish the big picture all at once. You have to start at the bottom, build the foundation, and at the end, you'll have the result you want.
Being a special teams coach and special teams coordinator, you got to deal with and interact with an entire football team. You got to deal with guys on the bottom of the roster. You've got to deal with people being injured, plus veteran guys that you need on specials. How are those experiences helpful for you transitioning now to this job?
Well, I think the most valuable thing I learned doing special teams is dealing with all 53 on the roster. And it's about using what you have available to you. It's about everyone getting to buy into the vision of the team, that they have to do whatever they need to do to let the team be successful in that specific game plan that week against a particular opponent. You've got to deal with everyone. That's different personalities. That's different individual goals. That's different skill sets. You have to find a way to reach everybody, to teach them, and you have to find everyone to inspire them to go out there and execute to the best of their ability. And that's really what coaching is finding a way to teach your players and get them to go out there and execute to the best of their ability.
All right, we got another one from a Giants fan. Alex in Florida wants to know, how do you plan on utilizing Saquon Barkley in the offense this upcoming season?
We're going to look to use our roster top to bottom however we can, and week by week it may be a little bit different. I've got to go in right now and dive into watching this tape and get an expert view from an insider's view. Right now I have an outside point of view on the team, and I'd be going ahead and giving false information if I tried to go ahead and make predictions right now on anyone on our roster.
Did the job become even more attractive to you? Obviously, you want to be a head coach, but knowing that you're going to a place where there is a young quarterback in place and not having to deal with transitioning of veteran quarterbacks, there's a young guy that's got some pelts on the wall as far as playing experience his rookie year, and a guy who's put up some pretty good numbers.
I think the entire roster right now has ability to develop and to compete with anybody in this league. It's going to take time to develop, all right, to become fundamentally sound, and to make sure that we can go out there and situationally execute. So this job was very appealing to me for a lot of reasons, one of which was the city itself. I think the team has to reflect the fans that it appeals to. It's got to have a hard-nosed, blue-collar mentality. That's the way I was raised. That's the way I believe a football team should be. It's refreshing being in an environment that expects the same. I look forward to seeing the fans out there as well, and we want to give them what they expect to see, which is the neighborhoods they grow up in, all right, and the result they want to see.
All right, what's your message in closing? What's your number one message right now as you speak to Giants fans as we sit here and do this interview about yourself and about your program and what you hope to bring here?
Look, we're going to play fast. We're going to play tough. We're going to go out there every week, and we're not going to beat ourselves. And that's the goal right now of a football team. I'm not into predictions. I'm not into comparisons. You know, this team going forward has to work on the little details, all right? And we want to put a product on the field that's going to make people proud to say they're a Giants fan. We're going to play tough for you. That you have my word on. If they won't play tough, they won't be on the field. We're not going out there. I'm not worried about some guru scheme. I'm not worried about how fancy we can try to make an offense or defense look. I want to line up. I want to punch the guy in the nose for 60 minutes, all right? And at the end of the day, we know we dominated the man against us, and we won the outcome.
Welcome to the New York Giants, Coach. We appreciate a few minutes.
Pleasure to be here.
That's the 19th head coach in the history of the New York Giants, Joe Judge. For more on Coach Judge, you can always visit the Giants at facebook.com/NewYorkGiants, at giants.com, on Twitter at Giants, and always on the Giants app.
Hey, Giants fans, Saquon Barkley here. You want to see more videos? Subscribe below.